time for Pennzoil Truck Series Chase Race number 3. We're here short track racing in Richmond, Virginia. This is the Safelite 250 at the Richmond Raceway. On the pole for tonight's race, the 13 of Justin Idell, last race winner at Talladega, and beside him in second, Chaser John Smith in the 60. Then in third place is the points leader Zachary DeLello. Fourth place, we have Tim Randolph, and ranking out the top five, Chase Buck in the 31. Starting in sixth, we have Marshall Burrell. Seventh place is Levi Jones. Luke Green needs something to go right here in this chase. He starts eighth. In ninth place, it's Kirsten Clark, and Evan Hunter, 47, rounds out the top 10. Back behind them, Nathan Stapleton, 42, trying to get back up into the chase picture. And who's outside second in points, Scott Gregory, the 5. Then we have Keyshawn Richardson and Racer, the 09, along with Anthony Hernandez and Chaser Anson and Charles Bois. Then we have Danny Lloyd and Riley Sproulytube in the 16, along with Chaser Jack Cannaramo and the 18 of Trey Rainey. Then there's Walker Davis and Matthew Swells, the 51, along with CJ Whitehorse and the 10 of William Seaman. Then we have Chaser Landon Lyons and the 9 of Alex Fletcher, along with Chaser Jose Mills and the 17 of Silas Orta. Then there's Danny Bright, 33, and 30 Michael Gregory Chaser, Riley Snare Chaser, the 11, and Mitchell Collins in the 08. Then we have Jonathan Beaufort and Colton Yeo, and rounding out the field, Lee Romanica Chaser and the 63 truck of Christopher Choi. There is our 36 truck starting lap for racing in the third chase race of the season here at Richmond. Let's go on track side to fire these trucks up for short track racing in the Pennzoil Truck Series season number 9 chase.
Drivers, start your engines!
Very 6 trucks rolling for short track racing. 38 laps in the Safelite 250 chase race number 3 of 8 here in the Pennzoil Truck Series season number 9. Last race runner Zaydell starts on pole, and our points leader starts third, looking to keep the momentum going here in this chase. Zaydell will be the first to step on the gas. He's away. We're green flag racing at Richmond. The points leader already getting down to the bottom lane. DeLello for the lead. Zaydell leads the first lap here in the Safelite 250. But the points leader, Zachary DeLello, moves out front already on lap number 2. He's the new race leader here at Richmond. Chase Buck falls into second. Levi Jones to third. Fourth place now Kirsten Clark. And Nathan Stapleton moving up. Finished highest of the chasers at Pocono, but last race not a great one for him at Talladega. Looking to turn around here in the 42 truck. He's moving now for a spot inside the front five early on here in the Safelite 250 as his championship rival, Zachary DeLello, leads. But here comes Kirsten Clark with a nice run to turn three. She'll get underneath the 03 barely, sends him up the racetrack. DeLello goes wide, and Kirsten Clark moves out in front on lap number 3 here at Richmond. But now Nathan Stapleton run down to the inside the 42 truck. Stapleton moves down to the bottom, and Chaser Stapleton out in front. Racer moves through to second. And the 7 of Hernandez up to third. They have Danny Lloyd to fourth. And behind them, Cannaramo Chaser rubs into Chaser DeLello. Now they'll be three wide with Mathis Wells to the inside. Winner Pocono 2 races ago. And led the most up to Talladega last race. He's had a great last 2 races. Looking at another great result. Moves through inside the front 5 as Racer moves to the front in the 09. Hernandez to second. Still 3 wide. Cannaramo gets into Kirsten Clark big time. Setting the 20 wide. They keep it going straight, but a ton of contact there between those two. But we keep it straight. John Smith forcing DeLello to the outside. All these chasers, their one goal is to move that 03 aside and get him as far back as possible by as many chasers as possible. Right there, that move out of Smith put the 60, 54, 11, and 30 by him. That's 4 points right there because the 03 went wide. And DeLello's still fading back now outside the top dozen. And if he stays on the outside, he'll be outside the top 15 this lap. Here comes a chaser, Lever Mix, our last row, 35th, moving down to his inside, and that's another point that DeLello will lose right there. And right now, DeLello only has Landon Lyons, a chaser behind him, and I believe that's Anson and Charbois as well. I believe those are the only two chasers back behind him. At the front, Nathan Stapleton led that lap. Hernandez the 7 will now move to the inside, and he'll get it away in 3 and 4. Danny Lloyd will move up to second now. Behind them, chasers duke it out. Luke Rainey outside, Riley Snare inside. they're right now kind of middle of the road in terms of how the chasers have performed so far these first two races. He's still kept himself in this contention in case someone like DeLello has better to right now he is, and even Scott Gregory. Snare now move into the highest chaser point of 12. Right behind him, Michael Gregory, number one seed in this chase. So we thought a lot of things were going to go right for him. Had a decent day at Pocono, got fourth highest chaser points there. Last race at Talladega, not his day at all. Now he has 12 points just behind Snare and others, and points around seventh in the point standings. So we'll see if Michael Gregory can try and turn his chase around after two kind of, I wouldn't say Pocono's a mediocre day, but last race at Talladega, definitely not the day he was looking for, as Riley Snare moves to the front here in lap number 11. Gregory falling through to second position. Right now, chasers run 1-2 in the Safelite 250. Here comes Colton Yo up to third in the zero. The Tennesseeman as well. Luke Rainey falling through on the inside for Luke. He needs to go basically all out now in this chase. If he wants to have a shot at this championship, race wins are going to need to be happening for this 21 truck. Every single race, he has to be within a shot at the race victory at the end. Through the first two chase races, he scored a total of 4 points, averaging to a race already. Zachary DeLello is up to 21. So he's over a full race behind DeLello's points lead. And he's racing like it. Three wide to the bottom. Nothing to lose for this 21 and a lot to gain. Rubbing with order down the back to turn three. Luke Rainey's going for it. Oh, there they go up into the wall. Riley Snare and Salas Orta. Chaser Snare rubs up a few more. We keep it going straight. We're still green for now, but they're four wide entering turn one. Buford backs out. Snare still rubbing with the 17. Buford onto the apron. Trucks get away. We're still green, though, in Richmond. And what has this done to the pack but split it up? And DeLello's at the back of this train. This huge pack that got held up, DeLello's at the back of it. Look at how this has impacted this race. There's Orta. How about Snare's on the 17th, still right now in 11th position. Snare's still going. He actually just gained some spots. He's still moving forward, even with that damage in the 11 truck, but it has split the field up now. Three trucks have gotten away with the race lead. Luke Rainey, Walker Davis, and William Seaman. Then fourth on back, Danny Bright, Mitchell Collins. Then there's Snare, still trucking along in that 11 truck. Even with all that damage, he made contact numerous times with different trucks, but he's now moving for fourth in the 11, so he's obviously not slowed down. May have gotten a little tighter, though. Yeah, damage can definitely make these trucks tighter, and you can see it right there. He got up into Danny Bright, almost wrecked him. Now they're three wide for fourth. Danny Lloyd to the inside, the 15. And they're trying to run down the front three. Right now, they are doing it. They were about a tenth to four tenths faster than these trucks in front. Coming back to 21 to go. They can run them down, but they can't do it right there. Danny Lloyd went wide. They have to be disciplined, as right now the front three are single file, but now they're going to break that up. Here comes Seaman to the inside of Luke Rainey. Walker Davis to follow through on the inside as well. They're three wide again. Michael Gregory forcing it inside of Riley Snare. Snare has to be disciplined here. He can't wash up the track like he did the last two times. And the 30 and 11 are beating and banging. Two chasers. Rubin is racing here at Richmond. Gregory by Snare. Now to the back bumper of Lloyd. Lloyd to the back of Yo. Peeking down to the inside for fourth. Lloyd gets that spot, but if they keep battling, they will not run these front three down. A 22. That's about what Luke Rainey ran, and slower than what Davis ran, who's right now the race leader. But Davis goes wide through 1 and 2. This is Luke Rainey's chance to try and move for the race lead again. And if no yellow flag comes out, this is Luke Rainey's biggest chance to win here in this chase so far. He's right now the only chaser up here, and he has a 33% chance, if it stays green, and it's only these three trucks, to win this race. But the yellow is out right there. Alex Fletcher has crashed off turn four, and we're going to have a reset button here late in the going at Richmond. So just after the midway point, caution flag comes out. Chaser Luke Rainey leads us back around. Seaman and Davis second and third. Collins, Lloyd round out the front five. And a late yellow flag here. Alex Fletcher crashed off turn number four. Heavy damage to the 9 truck. Let's go see what caused it. Our first yellow flag is out here in the Safelite 250. Three wide racing off into turns 3 and 4. Zachary DeLello trying to make his way back up through the field after falling back to 36th position. He's three wide on the bottom. Fletcher in the middle. CJ Whitehorse up top. And right here, Fletcher just kind of washes up the track. CJ Whitehorse is up there. They both make contact hard, impacting the outside safety barrier for Alex Fletcher. See the ton of damage in that 9 truck. CJ Whitehorse got some side damage. Got down to Landon Lyons. Riley Spurto as well collected. as he hit the 9 as he came off the wall. So a hard impact for the 9 of Fletcher brings out our first caution flag here in the Safelite 250 as they got 3 wide entering 3 and 4 as DeLello making big moves to the field, but I don't really think he instigated that. I think that was just Fletcher kind of washing up the racetrack. Whitehorse couldn't move up much more. They ran out of real estate, and this is the end result. A few trucks get damage off of this, and a crazy Richmond race so far. Chaser Luke Rainey looking to get it done here and get himself back into championship contention. Luke Rainey leads the Safelite 250 at Richmond. Green flag will wave with 12 laps of racing to go here at Richmond. So we're down to the final laps in this chase race. Three trucks are out. Alex Fletcher, Riley Spurrier, and CJ Whitehorse. Obviously a little bit more damage than what we saw to the 16 and the 71. Maybe a little more internal damage there to those two. 33 trucks left running. Points there. DeLello right now. Ryan's in 19th. Decent day for him right now, trying to get as many points as he can out of it. Can Luke Rainey hang on? Second place, William Seaman, Walker Davis, Mitchell Collins, and Danny Lloyd. Next time chase are Michael Greger and Riley Snare, 7th and 8th. Rang up the top 10, Colton Yeo and Anthony Nez. We're back, Green at Richmond. A decent jump for everyone inside the front five. And no one really got away there. No real gaps there, but Luke's going to go up the racetrack for the race lead. Seaman has a run down to the inside. Racing to turn 3, can Luke Rainey chop him off? He can't. Seaman down to the inside. Mitchell Collins, the only driver this season to complete every single lap. Moving up to third. Behind them, they're 3 wide. Riley Snare on the outside. Snare's going to get clear of the 7, but can't get clear of the 0. Yeo keeps it down bottom. Here comes Trey Rainey and Christopher Choi. Choi started last in this race. And moving up now to try and get inside the top 10. Snare in line in front of him. Here comes Yolo on Lloyd for the race lead. Mitchell Collins on William Seaman. Collins is by in turns 1 and 2. 9 to go at the line. Luke Rainey coming back. Danny Bright with them. And Michael Gregory as well. Two chasers inside the front 5 here at Richmond. And one of which needs to win to try and have any hopes at going for a championship. For Michael Gregory, Kim is number 1 seed trying to turn it back around. Michael Gregory to 4th. Danny Bright now looking for the race and gunning on the inside and getting by easily. Danny Bright out front now in Richmond. Michael Gregory through to 2nd. And there comes Seaman low on Luke Rainey. Behind them, John Smith starting to emerge at the front, the 60 truck. He's had so far a pretty decent chase. A good points tonight for him could mean a lot in terms of going for this championship. How about Scott Gregory, 2nd in points, trying to get the points away from DeLello, who's right now further back. Scott Gregory now moving up inside the top 15, maybe even the top 10. At the front, Gregory goes wide. Here comes Seaman to the inside with 7 to go. William Seaman now for the race in turns 1 and 2. Maybe some contact with the 33. And Trey Rainey up to 2nd in the 18. Winner at Charlotte earlier this season. John Smith right now the highest chaser right now moves to 3rd. Danny Bright line 4th and chaser Luke Rainey to 5th. Scott Gregory emerging inside the front 10. Trey Rainey for the lead and get by Seaman in turns 1 and 2 with 6 to go. Now Trey goes wide. Here comes John Smith with a huge run. He easily got by the 18. Chaser John Smith out front. Danny Bright will move to 2nd. And behind them, Chaser Luke Rainey, Chaser Scott Gregory, Chaser Riley Snare, all the inside with a shot. Michael Gregory, Chaser on the outside. And have they slowed because there's a yellow flag? There is a yellow! This will probably end the race. Two chasers involved. Can John Smith beat Danny Bright back around? Can Danny Bright get to the inside? He'll battle it out to John Smith. Back around. Danny Bright back around front. In all likelihood, he's going to win at Richmond under the yellow flag. 4 to go. No time to clean this track up because of that. And if Danny Bright's truck can hold on, he's going to win in Richmond. John Smith will get a good points tonight in 2nd, but oh so close to victory for the 60. As it looks like Nathan Stimpson and Lee are making 2 chasers involved in a crash to end this race short. Let's go quickly see what happened. So watch here, Nathan Stapleton pretty good ways ahead of Learmank in the 29 truck as they race off to turn 3. Minnick tries to get in front of the 22 Keyshawn Richardson. Keyshawn gives him a bump up the track that gets into Nathan Stapleton and both the trucks go spinning. Look at Minnick up off the ground in the 29. Hard contact there into the outside safe rear for Leroy Minnick. Nathan Stimpson as well. 2 chasers crash out here in the Safelite 250 at Richmond. And bad points tonight for both of them. That's big news for Stapleton, who's trying to get back up there. And Leroy Minnick, who's also came in 3rd in points. Not going to leave 3rd in points after what just happened. The All-Star Minnick tried to get down. Keyshawn was down there. 22 gave him the 29 bump. Got up into the 4-2. They lost control. Look how close it was for John Smith. as Denny Bright makes the move in turn 3 and 4. The yellow flag comes out, and right there, down to the inside, Danny Bright moves around Smith, back around, and by a little less than half a truck length, Danny Bright is going to win here in Richmond. Three chasers follow through to the checkered flag. We'll come back and see Danny Bright take the checkers to win. Three chasers will finish inside the front five here tonight, but a non-chaser is going to score victory. Danny Bright, his second of the season, he's going to win, and another short track, this time in Richmond, Virginia, spoiling the chasers party once again. So far, no chasers have won chase races this season. John Smith, oh so close, couldn't get done. Luke Rennie, a great rebound after two bad points races. But Danny Bright wins the night out at Richmond, his second victory of the season. And now let's go see the finishing results. Now the points are affected after a chaotic race here in Richmond. Here is how they finished in the third chase race of the season, the Safelite 250 at the Richmond Raceway. Two caution flags for 9 laps here tonight, but 22 lead changes, 14 different drivers saw the lead tonight in Richmond. And for Danny Bright, got out front at just the right moment. Yellow flag comes out, he makes the pass, he wins here in Richmond. John Smith, Luke Gray, Scott Gregory, three chasers following through to the yellow flag. They end up second, third, and fourth. Great points tonight for all three of those guys. Scott Gregory for him moves them into the points lead. And for Trey Rennie, another top five here this season in the 18. Evan Hunter gets sixth, seventh place for William Steeman. Riley Snare Chaser gets eighth, Walker Davis ninth, and Michael Gregory the 30 rounds out the top 10. Five chasers finish inside the top 10 here tonight, but it was really feast or famine for chasers here tonight. Five inside the top 10, but no more inside the top 20. The next highest would be Zachary DeLello. Where did he finish? Well, it went from 10th all the way down to 22nd. So 11th to 21st had no chasers. DeLello next highest in 22nd. Bills in 23rd. Landline's 24th. 25th, Jack Canaramo. That was a huge string of chasers right there from 22nd down to 25th. And then chasers that really did not have great nights, Anson and Charles Bois, Nathan Stapleton, and Lever Minnick all down at the bottom. Not great points nights for them, especially for Stapleton and Charles Bois, who did not have great races before this one. It's at the right side, you see the updated points, and Scott Gregory now on top by a singular point over Zachary DeLello. Those two really run the table so far in this postseason. They right now 29 and 28 points, 1 point separate them. John Smith moving up nicely up to third, only five behind the point lead. Riley Snare as well up there, 7 points behind. Not too bad for the 11 driver. Those are right now the front four in points. And Michael Gregory rounds out the top five of the 30, only 9 points behind Scott Gregory. And then you look down, there's a lot of ties and whatnot down here. You can see with 18 points, Landon Lyons, and a lot of drivers with 16 points. Stapleton, Canaramo, Jose Mills, Lee Romanek has 17 as well, just ahead of that. Luke Rennie back up into contention to try and gain some spots. Now up with 15 points, just moved ahead of his wild card competitor, Anson and Charles Bois. So, obviously for Luke Rennie now back up, he's 14 points behind the points that is right now within a race. So he can technically leave next race as a tie for the points lead. Anson and Charles Bois now over a full race behind. He cannot leave next race as the points there. However, he can definitely make it closer as this chase is winding down. Three races in, five races to go this season, and the next one is going to be just as crazy as what we saw here tonight as we're going racing at the 1.5 mile racetrack in Chicagoland. We're going for the Gatorade 250. I will see you guys then.